like, you know, to keep sickness absence levels to level to just above the 4% through a pandemic, my view is quite incredible, and it's a testament to the people who are in this organisation.
Yes, indeed. And the role that we play as the strategic lead authority, we've also been preferring national statistics to ministers during the thick of the pandemic, that was daily. And we were sending up statistics every day, and then it dropped down to three times, I think it's once a week or twice a week now. I've seen those, and that tracks the position across the whole country. And whilst, of course, we're only interested, we are principally interested in Merseyside, it's interesting to see the figures across the whole country. It did go up, and you'd imagine and understand that, but did come right down again. And it has been tracked and has been monitored, and I think it's it is a testament to this Blue Line service and the staff and the dedication of our people to try and keep the public that we represent safe. And I'm sure we'll all want to send our grateful thanks to all of those who are involved. Thank you. So, the recommendation on page 293 is that members approve the attached report for publication on the website. I'll add to that that this also be considered by the scrutiny committee in its work plan. And agreed, colleagues? Okay. Well, thank you. Start of another year. Who knows what this year is going to bring. But thank you all, particularly in this sort of spaced out sort of situation, for working with it. And stay safe and see you at the next meeting when we have the opportunity to say I would like to try and see about the station visits and those type of informal so members can gather the information. Thank you. I'll close this meeting.
Thank you very much.